With a savage mask, staring alien eyes. Come now, Bertha!
Why must you call me that? That is not my name!
Oh, yes, it must be. Tonight and every night, it must be.
My name is Antoinette.
Oh, Antoinette, Antoinetta, Marionette, Marionetta. No, Bertha.
Bertha, my prize. Come now.
Let her shut you up!
I'm called Antoinette! You're a bad Antoinette! She's a cream on all my four roots! Antoinette Mason, you go to it!
My prize! Tied to a lunatic for life! Come, my lunatic, my mad girl! Let her shut you up!
No! She's a cream on all my four roots! She's a cream on all my four roots! She's a cream on all my four roots!
But this is nonsense, Antoinette. Particularly in this last hour. Everything arranged. But the present. Oh, God, what shall I tell your father?
I do not wish to marry him.
Edward, she won't go through with it. I've been arguing with a little fool for an hour.
But won't go through with what?
She won't marry him.
But why?
She won't give a reason.
You don't wish to marry me?
No.
Well, what's the matter, Antoinette? What have I done?
I'm afraid of what might happen.
Don't you remember last night I told you? When you are my wife, there will be no more reason to be afraid.
Yes. But then you laughed. I didn't like the way that you laughed.
But I was laughing at myself, Antoinette.
You don't know anything about me. About my past.
I'll trust you. If you trust me. Is that a bargain? You can't be dragged to the altar. But if you make me go away, I will go with a sad heart.
Your sad heart? Can you bring me peace?
Oh, Antoinette, I promise you I will do all I can to bring you happiness, safety, and peace. Shall I tell Richard you made a mistake? Dear Father, the £30,000 has been paid to me without question. I have a modest competence now. The woman is a stranger. She is thought to be beautiful, and she is. Those dark, alien eyes. And yet her pleading expression already annoys me. I have sold my soul to the devil, or you have sold it for me. Dear Father, the £30,000 has been paid to me without question. I have a modest competence now. I have been unwell and will write at greater length when I have settled in.
To come here to get away from the hot weather in June, July, and August. I came 3 times with my Aunt Cora. That was after.
If this is a sad story, don't tell me tonight.
It's not sad. Only some things happen and are there for always. I remember this night it was very hot. The window was shut, so I asked Christophine to open it. It was so hot that my night chemise was sticking to me. But I went to sleep all the same. Suddenly I was awake. I saw the moon staring at me.
And that's the story.
It was a full moon that night. And it shone on me. Next morning, Christophine was very angry. She said it was very bad to sleep in the moonlight when the moon is full. I never told anyone till now. Do you think I slept too long in the moonlight?
You're safe with me. Remember? Happiness, safety, and peace. I never know how to share my feelings. I don't know how young I was when I learned that.
I never wished to live before I knew you. Why did you make me want to live?
Because I wished it.
Suppose one day you didn't wish it. Suppose you took all this happiness away when I wasn't looking.
And lose my own. Who'd be so foolish?
I'm not used to happiness. It makes me afraid.
Never be afraid. Or if you are, tell no one.
Thank you.
could you do that? Stay die and watch me die.
Who are you?
My name is Cosmere, like your wife's.
What do you want?
Take this letter, read it. Then you ask Richard Pearson three simple questions. Ask him if your wife's mother is a real lunatic. Ask if she'll go the same way. And ask him if they all know it.
You're talking about my wife! This letter just came from someone called Coswig. You don't know anything about me? About my past? Well, now I do.
Then I saw the jagged rock in her hand and she threw it, and her face cracked. crumpled. We stared at each other. Blood on my face, tears on hers like in a looking glass. Fear died in my mother's arms. And after that, she was dead too. She blamed Mr. Mason.
Coward! I will kill you!
And she was sent away. One day, I went to see her. And she held me so close like never before. And I said, he's dead now, but I'm here. And she looked at me.
No. No, no, no!
And she pushed me away. I fell and I banged my head again. Then I was sent to the convent. The convent was my refuge. It was a place of sunshine and death, a place of sunshine, a place of peace, a place of safety. Then Aunt Cora told me she had to go to England. I embroider my cushion. My flowers are purple and green. I write my name in fire red. My name is Antoinette Mason, New Causeway. Later, Richard said that I must marry and that I would be happy. And he promised me happiness, safety.
I don't meddle in that.
If I could make him come to me just one more time, then everything would be all right. Please, Christophine, just one night. I have the money.
Don't give me money. I do this foolishness because you're desperate.
I do not hate you. I'm most distressed about you. I'm distraught.
Then why do you never come near me? Or kiss me? Or talk to me? Why do you think I can bear it? What reason have you for treating me like this? Have you any reason?
Yes, I have a reason.
Well, tell me then.
Is your mother alive?
No. She's dead. She died.
When?
Not long ago.
Then why did you tell me she died when you were a child?
Because they told me to say so, and because it is true. There are always two deaths, the real one and the one that people know about.
The letter I received from the man who calls himself Daniel Causeway.
He has no right to that name. His real name, if he has one, is Daniel Boyd. He hates all white people, but he hates me the most. He tells lies about us, and he is sure that you will believe them and not listen to the other side.
Is there another side?
There is always another side, always. I know what he told you. That my mother was a mad, infamous woman. And that my little brother who died was born a cretin, an idiot. And that I'm a mad girl too. That's what he told you, isn't it?
Yes. Is any of it true? We won't talk now. Rest tonight.
But we must talk about it now. I might not be able to tell you about it in any other place or at any other time. Are you frightened?
But why not tell me tomorrow, in the daylight?
You have no right to ask questions about my mother and then refuse to listen to my answer.
Of course I will listen. Of course we can talk now, if that's what you wish.
To me too.
but for her it was strange and frightening. I used to think that every time she looked in the glass, she must have hoped and pretended.
I pretended two different things, of course.
You could pretend for a very long time. But one day it all falls away and you're alone. We were alone in the most beautiful place in the world. It's not possible that there can be anywhere else so beautiful as Calubri. Then they poisoned our hearts.
And you? What about you?
I was never sad in the morning. And every day was fresh for me.
All the flowers in the world were in our garden. And sometimes after a shower, I'd lick the raindrops off the jasmine leaves.
If I could make you see it. Because they destroyed it and it's only in here now.
But I thought you said you were always happy.
No. I said I was always happy in the morning, not always in the afternoon, and never after sunset.
After sunset, the house is haunted.
It was night when they burned down Calubri. There's nothing left now. Next morning, my head was bandaged because someone had thrown a stone at me. Aunt Cora told me it was healing and that it wouldn't spoil me on my wedding day. But I think it did spoil me on my wedding day. And all other days and nights.
Antoinette, your nights are not spoiled, all your days. Put the sad thing away. Don't think about it and nothing will be spoiled, I promise.
Pierre died from the smoke from the fire. My mother hated Mr. Mason. She said she would kill him. And she tried to. After that, he bought a house and hired a colored man to look after her. He almost forgot her.
And you forgot her too.
I'm not a forgetting person. But she didn't want me. When I went to see her, she pushed me away and cried. I was not Pierre. They told me I made her worse. One day I made up my mind to go and see her by myself. There was a colored man with a glass of rum in his hand. He said, "Drink, and you will forget." She drank without stopping. She took the glass and threw it over her shoulder, smashed to pieces. I saw his mouth fasten on hers. She went all weak and limp in his arms. And then she laughed.
Don't laugh like that, Bertha.
Bertha is not my name. Why do you call me Bertha?
Because it's a name I'm particularly fond of. Almost an English name. I think of you as Bertha.
It doesn't matter.
When you went out this morning, where did you go?
I went to see Christopher.
And why did you go to see her?
I went to ask her to do something for me.
And did she do it? I want to do the best for both of us. So much of what you tell is strange, different from what I was led to expect. Don't you feel that if you went away from this place, or if I went away, it could be the wisest thing we could do? Bertha, are you ill? Why don't you answer me?
You go. I wish to stay here in the dark, where I belong.
Oh, nonsense.
Your mouth is colder than my hands.
Sleep now. We'll talk tomorrow.
Yes, but will you stay just a little longer? With a glass of wine?
Certainly I will. My dear Bertha.
Not Bertha tonight.
Of course, on this of all nights, you must be Bertha.
Thank you.
did you say?
You're not well, sir.
She had lit all the candles, and the room was full of shadows. The light changed her. I'd never seen her look so gay or beautiful. She poured wine into two glasses and handed one to me. But I swear it was before I drank that I longed to bury my face in her hair as I used to do. She need not have done what she did to me. I will always swear that she need not have done it. When she handed me the glass, she was smiling. I remember putting out the candles, and that is all I remember. All I will remember of the night.
Your sweet honeymoon, sir. Is it over?
I feel betrayed.
Mr. Rochester.
So much prettier than me.
I'll open the window and let some air in.
But let the night air in too. And the moon. The scent of those flowers that you dislike so much.
Bertha!
Bertha is not my name. You tried to make me into somebody else when you call me that. That is Obeya too.
Don't drink anymore.
Touch me once, You'll see I'm not a coward like you. Don't you love me at all?
Think of hurricanes and my revenge. Pity. Like a naked newborn babe striding the blast. Pity. Is there none for me? Tied to a lunatic for life. A drunken, lying lunatic gone her mother's way. She thirsts for anyone, not for me. She's played her games, her mother's games, so often that the lowest jeer at her. And I knew nothing of this. The secret, the dark secret that lay behind dark, alien eyes. She is made for loving, but she'll have no lover. For I don't want her, and she'll have no other. She said she loved this place. This is the last she'll see of it. I'll watch for one human tear. Listen for her to say adieu, like she used to sing in those songs. If she says it, or weeps, I'll take her in my arms. My lunatic. Oh, she's mad. But mine, mine, if she smiles, or weeps, or both, for me. Antoinette, I can be gentle too. Hide your face, hide yourself, but in my arms, my lunatic. My mad girl.
The man who hates me is calling out, Bertha, Bertha! And I hear the parrot screeching. But when I look over the edge, I see all the colors in the world. The purple of the forest, the soft green moss of the garden wall. And the pool is there, and Tia, you're frightened, I hear her say. And the sky is so red. The wind catches my hair, and it streams out, and I know it'll burn me up. Alas, I know why I was